Hello everyone, it's Elena and I'm back with another video, and today I'm going to share with you guys my organization system because as a law student I have lots of assignments and readings to do, so I can't really rely on just remembering when they're due. So yeah, I think we've all at some point experienced that stress of realizing something was already due, so don't put yourself in that position. So my organization system is aimed at organizing all my tasks, making sure that I find them, and that I don't end up writing something frantically hours after the actual deadline. When I came up with my organization system, I thought about the tasks that I have to do on a weekly basis or at least a regular basis, and then I needed to find a system which could accommodate all of these, even though they vary in urgency, importance, and therefore priority. A method that I find useful for seeing which type of task your organization system needs to accommodate is the Eisenhower matrix. Under that matrix, you organize your tasks according to urgency and importance. So you can have tasks which are urgent but not important, some which are both, some which are not urgent and not important, and then some which are not urgent but nonetheless important. So for example, for me, my supervision essays, they are urgent because I have a deadline on them, but they're actually not important because they don't count towards my grade at all. Another thing is, for example, my blog posts, they're neither urgent nor important because this is literally just a hobby, even though I really love to do it. Supervision readings, on the other hand, are both urgent and important because there's a deadline on them and they are my exam preparation, so these are my top priority. And then things like revision notes are very important, but they're actually not urgent throughout the year because, well, my exams are at the end of the year. So the app I use for all these different types of tasks is ThingsFree. ThingsFree is amazing because it allows you to add lists for important but also not so important tasks, and you don't get confused about their priority thanks to the ability to put them into different lists, put them into categories, and then also flag them with the help of a deadline. You can star them. So there are lots of ways that you can make sure that you see the most important tasks first, but that you also have lists for the less important tasks. So for example, you can make a list for your YouTube and blog or whatever it is that you have. You can always see how far you've gotten on that list, and then you can organize the list quite a lot because you can add headings, which is something that for some reason is quite rare in to-do apps, at least from what I have seen. But I find it super useful because it just allows you to give much more structure to your individual lists. You can add some notes to your different to-dos so that you can see what exactly is going on. I find it very useful for just like a few lines of notes, but not too much. And yeah, you can have lists for pretty much anything. You can also set different categories. So for example, I have a daily category within which I have different lists for every day, just so that, you know, they're all in one place. Or I have a revision category and then a list for every subject. And the great thing is all your to-dos come together in this today section. So no matter which list this is in, the task will pop up there when the deadline is near, which is super useful because it brings all your tasks back together. Another great thing about ThingsFree is that it's available for the iPhone and the iPad, so I have it on all my devices and never need to, you know, use a post-it, which I will never find again, in order to remind myself of a to-do. Now, I do use ThingsFree for an overview of all my tasks, but then I actually make a daily to-do list. I usually use the Apple Calendar just because it's very quick to do, so I use a method called calendar blocking for this, where you block out chunks of time for different tasks. Now, I know this calendar looks super busy, but it's actually not that busy because I also block out chunks of time for free time and also just for things like my morning routine, because I find that gives you just a lot more structure in quarantine, which is really important because you've lost all your structure from lectures. So what I do in my calendar is I go to whatever block that I scheduled for these type of tasks, and then I just go to the notes section and add the different to-dos from ThingsFree. So I just literally copy them and leave it there. So once I'm working, I just go into my calendar, I quickly check what to-dos I wrote down so that I know what I'm supposed to be doing. And yeah, that's pretty much how I just make a quick daily to-do list. Super easy to do, and it keeps also your time planning in the same place as your to-dos, so you can always check whether you're still on schedule. While it's really important to stay on top of all your to-dos, it's also really important to then stay on top of your documents that you're going to be working with, because if you have loose papers everywhere, you're not going to be able to find that one document that you're planning to study from in that chunk of time that you scheduled, and then your system is already starting to fall apart again. Now, there are two types of documents you need to organize: digital ones and hard copies. Let's start with digital ones. So for digital ones, first of all, please clean up your desktop if it looks anything like that, because you're not gonna find that one document very quickly in there. And then once you've cleaned it up, put all of your documents for the relevant subjects in organized folders. So personally, I have a folder for every year at university and then subfolders for every subject that I'm studying within that year. I also just have some stuff like preparation for the year, my lecture timetable, and then reports for my teachers in that folder for the particular year. Now let's take a look at these subject folders. So for example, within my international law folder, I then have another subfolder. I know I'm a big folder fan, but I have another subfolder for my supervisions. And there, all of them are labeled according to the topics and the number of the supervisions so that it's all organized. And within that, I have all my reading notes, then the questions that my teacher asked about the reading and my answers to them, and then also my notes from the supervision itself. Supervision is basically like a small seminar. And then also any readings I had to get from the internet, I just saved the PDFs in that folder in case I want to go back to them. And then within my international law folder, I also have another subfolder for just organizational files, for example, guidance on how to submit essays, etc., any summer work that I did, and of course, all of my lecture handouts. So that way you have a more organized and clean system of where you can find things, and it's super easy to find all of your digital documents. Now within Apple, you can actually take any folder that you have and you can just drag it to the sidebar, then you have much quicker access to it. I find it really, really useful just because it is super easy to access these things then. So I prefer doing that for all of my yearly folders. I don't know, maybe you guys will find that useful. Now let's get to hard copies because these are the papers that are likely flying around everyone's room. I also use folders in real life. So what I do is I just organize them with dividers. So for example, in my international law folder, I just have a world map just for orientation because it helps with the course. Then a general section with any course guidance, then a lecture section for our lecture handouts, a supervision section for any supervision work, a glossary section, and then an essay section. So these are all the essays I write throughout the term. But if you nonetheless find any papers flying around your room, maybe because, you know, they fell out of the folder, then here's what I do in order to make sure that I'm able to put them back where they belong. I really solved this problem with the document setup that I use. So whenever I make a new document in Pages, I always add the subject and then also the supervision number to the header or the lecture number, whatever it is, just to make sure I know where this belongs. And then I also add page numbers. The great thing is with Pages, you just click on the footer and it allows you to insert page numbers. What I like to do is I like to use the page numbers which say page one of so-and-so. So because then you have a header which clearly guides you to the right supervision and subject, and then you also have this 1 out of 4 which will tell you, okay, this is probably, you know, your reading notes because they're longer, or if it's just 1 out of 2 pages, it's probably your supervision notes. So it's very easy to then figure out where this belongs. And now lastly, let's get to notes that you take on to-dos, which aren't, you know, just a to-do, but rather like a bigger project, like for example, writing a post, doing research on an essay, stuff like that. And whenever you have an idea, you write it down on a post-it and you hope you will come across it again. So I use this, for example, for YouTube videos, my newsletter, and blog posts. And the app that I use to organize all of that is Notion. So Notion is an amazing organization tool. So you can make lists of pretty much anything. So for example, here for my newsletter, I have different sections for book recommendations, TV show recommendations, quotations, random facts, any articles I want to recommend, and any music that I liked. So you can just list them all in Notion and then you can go back to it whenever you are writing that thing and then you can benefit from it. You can also make lists for pretty much anything. They have amazing templates. It's super useful. So would highly recommend checking it out if you are planning to write more extensive notes for longer to-dos, which aren't just, you know, writing down what you gotta do. And yeah, that's my organization system. I hope you guys found this video helpful. Thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.